Good morning and a very warm welcome to each one of you. I bring you greetings from the Leprosy Mission Trust India. I would like to thank Reverend Dr. Paul Swarup for this opportunity to speak on the occasion of Leprosy Sunday. The theme for today's message is the healing touch based on 2 Kings chapter 5 verses 1 to 15. Let me read that. Now Naaman was commander of the army of the king of Aram. He was a great man in the sight of his master and highly regarded, because through him the Lord had given victory to Aram. He was a valiant soldier, but he had leprosy. Now bands of raiders from Aram had gone out and had taken captive a young girl from Israel, and she served Naaman's wife. She said to her mistress, "If only my master would see the prophet who is in Samaria, he would cure him of his leprosy." Naaman went to his master and told him what the girl from Israel had said. "By all means go," the king of Aram replied. "I will send a letter to the king of Israel." So Naaman left, taking with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 sets of clothing. The letter that he took to the king of Israel read, "With this letter, I am sending my servant Naaman to you, so that you may cure him of his leprosy." As soon as the king of Israel read the letter, he tore his robes and said, "Am I God? Can I kill and bring back to life? Why does this fellow send someone to me to be cured of his leprosy? See how he is trying to pick a quarrel with me." When Elisha, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his robes, he sent him this message. "Why have you torn your robes? Have the man come to me and he will know that there is a prophet in Israel." So Naaman went with his horses and chariots and stopped at the door of Elisha's house. Elisha sent a messenger to say to him, "Go wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan and your flesh will be restored and you will be cleansed." But Naaman went away angry and said, "I thought that he would surely come out to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God, wave his hands over the spot and cure me of my leprosy. Are not Abana and Pharpar, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? Couldn't I wash in them and be cleansed?" So he turned and went off in a rage. Naaman's servants went to him and said, "My father, if the prophet had told you to do some great thing, would you not have done it? How much more then when he tells you, 'Wash and be cleansed'?" So he went down and dipped himself in the Jordan 7 times, as the man of God had told him, and his flesh was restored and became clean like that of a young boy. Then Naaman and all his attendants went back to the man of God. He stood before him and said, "Now I know that there is no God in all the world except in Israel. So please accept a gift from your servant." From this passage, from verses 1 to 3, we see the physical condition of Naaman. He was a military leader of one of the most powerful nations. In fact, the commander-in-chief of the army of the king of Aram. He was a valiant soldier, really a powerful man, a man of great accomplishments, and really enjoyed power. But they all seemed to vanish when he stared at himself in the mirror each day. He had leprosy and nothing could be done about that. Leprosy was a really feared disease in those days. People with leprosy were considered outcasts. They had to cry out, "Unclean, unclean," and they lived alone. Naaman's leprosy would have probably been in its early stages. He would have been able to conceal it until now. But although people respected him, no one touched him. And this really hurt him deeply. His leprosy was now beyond concealment with his clothes. It means a lot. A meaningful touch means a lot to each and every human being. Touch conveys acceptance. Can we imagine living without being touched? Naaman did not have to imagine. For him, this was a reality. Each one of us have our own problems. Many of the problems we try and conceal. Where do we need to be touched? Where do we need God's healing touch? From verses 4 to 12, we see the prescriptive cure. What do we do in such a situation? Where do we go for healing? In a word, we go down. While down is very contrary to the direction we are encouraged to go, down is the way we must go if we have to be healed. Down is the route that we must take if we want to be touched by God. We see many contrasts in Naaman's journey. Naaman, who was the commander-in-chief, he finds direction through a captive servant. Naaman, who was the conqueror, he finds help in a conquered nation, Israel. Naaman, who was a highly regarded man, learns of his treatment from a lowly prophet, Elisha. Naaman, who was a wealthy and valiant soldier, is cured in a dirty river, the Jordan. So what can we learn from this downward descent? We need people in our lives who look past our hotness. Naaman's wife's servant was a captive. She was a young girl from Israel. She was not intimidated by Naaman's power or position. She saw his pain. She knew of a pain reliever and she directed Naaman to where he could find help. We need humble people in our lives who look past us, look past our social standing and see our loneliness, who will touch us where we need it most. We need people in our lives who will demonstrate the four C's of a loving relationship, who have a genuine concern for us, who are committed to us, who will walk through the pain with us, who will maintain confidentiality, who will keep our struggles between ourselves, who will be consistent, who will maintain regular contact with us. We also need places in our lives that will provide us with safety and security. Israel was a conquered nation. To Naaman, it was a hopeless country which had nothing to offer, but spiritually it provided refuge. Israel became a safe place for Naaman. When he entered Israel, he was in the right place, but he met the wrong person. He met the king, and the king misunderstood what it was all about, and he thought Naaman only brought trouble for him. Many of us are in such situations. We may be in the right place, but we really do not get in touch with the right person, and that is God. We all need prophets in our lives who will lead us to the cure. So Naaman went to Elisha in Samaria. If Israel was a hopeless country, Samaria was even despised by the Israelites. And when Naaman appeared at the door of Elisha's house, Elisha sent out his servant. Until then, Naaman was very flexible. He was willing to travel to the prophet's remotest outpost. But when the servant showed up at the door with the instructions for the cure, he was really angry. Naaman almost rejected this opportunity for healing by getting angry that Elisha did not show up at the door to greet him. Elisha may not have been tactful, but he had a cure. Many times, God does not send his blessings to the people we want. He chooses the lowly people through ordinary means to accomplish his healing. We all need a prescription for our lives that will lead to a healing touch. Elisha's prescription for healing was bizarre. He said, "Go wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan and your flesh will be restored and you will be cleaned." Naaman doubted God's prescription for healing. He did not realize that the power was not in the water, but it was in obeying God. Healing always comes from doing what God commands. when God asks us to dip 7 times, 5 times or 6 times will not do. A humble person does not make his own personal choices. We may not always understand God's way of working, but by humbly obeying, we will receive God's blessing. In verses 13 and 15, we see the prostrating compliance. Why should we have an attitude of obedience? Peter answers that question. And all of you clothe yourselves with humility towards one another, because God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 5 and 6. When we humble ourselves, God lifts us up. Naaman humbled himself and he was touched by God and healed. Leprosy defined his earlier life, but God's healing touch redefined his later life. The experience of God's grace changed him completely. He went from being a sick man to a healed man, from an ungodly man to a righteous man, from a lost man to a saved man, from a great man to a gracious man, and from a commander of men to a servant. Here was a man that had felt the touch of God and was changed forever. We all desperately need the touch of God. Let us humble ourselves before God so that he can touch us and heal us. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for this gift of life. Teach us to be humble and obey you every step of the way. Thank you for using us for your glory and sharing what we have with those in need. Thank you for protecting each one of us and keeping us safe during this pandemic. Thank you. I would just like to thank the Green Park Free Church for the generous contribution. And we are an old organization, almost 147 years, and we reach out to people affected by leprosy and the marginalized through our healthcare institutions, vocational training centers, our community projects, research, training, advocacy, so that healing, inclusion, and dignity is a reality for people affected by leprosy. You're welcome to engage with us in this journey. Thank you.